Hello and welcome to yet another edition of Tackle Talk. Anyone who's not familiar with it, we've done a few now, but it's five items. We're going to run the rule for it and give you our opinion on it. So let's crack on. Right then, Dan, you're up first then, mate. Get that out of the way. I thought we'd done this before the cameras came on.
Okay, well, caught me here having a little bit of a break. I've got this handy little product by a company called Tackle Tidy.
Can you give me one too?
Yeah, nice. got one there as well. And you can see it's a phone holder plus a drink holder. I've got a lovely fetching red one.
I've got a green one, you can see down here.
And here we are, we've got an orange one here, which that's just the cup. You know, you get them between, was it £8 and £13, I believe, depending on which kind of version you go. You can have them any colour you want, whether with a phone holder as well, or just the cup. See, I've got the version to fit straight onto a 36mm box. You've got the version there which fits straight into a Preston bracket. That's coincidence, isn't it? They managed to somehow...
Just a little bit. I was going to say good fortune that we managed to sort it out. I'll tell you what I like though, mate. Mm-hmm. I've told you many a time before, I don't do hot drinks, which I know people think, how don't you do hot drinks when you go fishing and stuff like that? So you said coffee cup mold, a holder, yep. You think specific, but no, can of pop fits in as well.
It's a drink holder. You can put whatever, any kind of generic kind of drink in it you want. It's, you know, it's the same sort of size as what you get in your car. So as long as it fits in your car holder, it's going to fit into one of these.
And your phone is such an expensive bit of kit. We don't think about it when we're fishing. If that goes in the lake, you've lost more than fishing. You know, you've lost pictures,
absolutely,
emails, everything. And you don't, there's no home for it, is there?
No.
Ta-da!
Your drink, it always ends up knocked over on your side tray. You knock a fish or go grab a rod, it disappears all over the place. Your phone, it always ends up in your can of corn, in your tub of corn or in your pellets when you're fishing. But so no, lovely little device. You can put it somewhere a little bit out of the way. And you know, why not have a little bit of luxury whilst you're at work or whilst you're fishing?
Absolutely. And nice price point as well, mate. You sometimes get these little devices and you think, oh, they're nice. And then you think, well, not nice enough to spend that. But you don't get much for a tenner in that sort of area these days, do you?
No, not at all. They're a small company. You can see these are all 3D printed. They do loads of little bits and pieces, like they do dividers and stuff for you. For your boxes, I actually got you a little present. I'll show you little later some nameplates to go on your box.
Oh, do, like, excellent!
Caps for your box, box legs, all sorts of little bits and pieces. So, Tackle Tidy, check them out. They do loads of lovely products.
Excellent! I tell you what, I haven't seen these stickers yet, but just imagine how much it's cost them to print my name. most of them are meant to go on the back of the box, but I can see mine spiraling around several times. So I can't wait to have a look at those.
Sorry, mate, I've just got them to initially. It's just TG.
Yeah, that's probably sensible. Right, next up. So, we are going to come back into, should we say, a more mainstream brand.
Yep.
And we are going to go with, first of all, Garbolino. Now, usually when we come out on these days out, we get some tackle out, we have a proper goal, get some stuff in the magazines. And today, it is the Garbolino Supra Match 11 and a half foot rod. Now, I believe from looking into things, these aren't actually that new.
Yeah.
But we couldn't actually get one last year because they came in, we sent inquiries out. Darren Cox, the loveliest man in England, says, I'd love to give you one, but the shop's already sold them out. And that's not even making it up. So that tells you something pretty quickly about these rods. Good price point at 100 quid. Yeah. And what I like about this one in particular is there's not many rods on the market these days where you can do a bit of old school waggler fishing with.
Yeah.
There are a lot of, they're 10 foot, 11 foot. They're a little bit stiffer and they're just, this has a little bit more give in the tip end while they're a little bit of power here.
Mm.
This is a proper, I call it the jack of all trades still water rod.
Back in the day, we'd call it a match rod.
You would. And it actually says match on it, which is a point to it. But I still think you could also, if you were chucking a pellet waggler a bit further, it's still got that bit of grunt with it. But at a time of year, it's getting a bit more autumnal where you need that bit more finesse and you're not chucking around big wagglers and catching two foot deep. This rod still does it. It's got, I say, it's a nice carbon weave down it, nice two-piece. Lovely rod. And for like 100 quid, which is, you know, that sort of mid-market bracket, I think, well, I was going to say they'll sell a lot, but they already have, ain't they? And I think the next batch are going to sell just as well.
I think you're right. Have a look at the EVA lower grip on the bottom of the handle.
Yeah.
It's kind of squared off and contoured. That's nice, that.
And that's usually something. Yeah, it is, but that's usually something you find on fader rods. Mm. It's obviously the punch, but, you know, you do need to still cast a waggler. And I just think, I like cork handles, because I think they just look, it's just aesthetics, isn't it? It's purely aesthetics. There's rods out there which are full on EVA, and they don't change the performance of the rod. But there's something nice about the cork handle, isn't there? And like you're saying, just, and now we're coming into, there's a lot of rods like this, aren't they? Touch of EVA for the comfort, with cork finishing it off. Usual things, reel seat, locks in nicely, hook keeper, and overall, a really nice rod, which is going to do more than one job. It's one of those where you think, oh, what do I want to do today? I'm going to go and fish for skimmers on an old school waggler, pick this up. Oh, I'm going to fish a bit further than usual. You know, maybe I'm chucking, you know, 30, 40 yards with a pellet waggler in summer, pick this up. And it's got the action, which is going to do a bit of everything. And at that sort of price, I think that's a brilliant thing, because we are in an era where some rods are a little bit one-dimensional, which is great when you do one type of fishing. But if you're a jack-of-all-trades angler who might go, to, say, down to your park lake, a club water, a commercial, and you just vary your float fishing a little bit, then this is the sort of thing I'd pay a good look at.
I like that. It's a little bit more than, like, your beginner kind of rods.
Absolutely.
Like your 50, sort of 60 quid rods. It's got that little bit extra finesse. However, we're not getting into that big bucks kind of range. It's the sort of thing where the experienced angler, who's got some years behind them, doesn't want to buy absolute tat, but then at the same time doesn't want to spend a fortune either.
Absolutely.
Nice, ideal, modest sort of price range.
It is, and a lot of the time people may have a 100 quid budget and they'll go and buy 250 quid rods to do two different jobs, while you could potentially spend your 100 quid on one rod that will do both jobs. You know, like you said, close to all the things we just said a moment ago. So a rod that's definitely worth a look, and I'm pretty sure they're going to sell the next batch of these pretty quickly again.
Yeah, so make sure you get straight down to the shops and have a look, because I think they're probably just going to sell them all straight out again, aren't they?
Definitely, but I'm going to ask Darren if I can keep this one, so we shall see. I'll probably
You'll
tell
be
me
lucky.
No.
You'll
I know,
be
I will lucky. Be lucky with the way they're selling. You're up.
Next up, I have some new floats from Simon Willsmore. Now, Simon is a top southern angler. You may well have heard of him. I say he does all sorts of smaller little kind of niche products that you will find in they're not massively widespread, but if you search properly online and check out some of the bigger retailers, you'll find some of his bits and pieces. And these are the Magic Roach. Now that may look a little bit familiar to you.
Well, I'll be honest with you, as more of a commercial angler, not so much. Yep. At my observations as a commercial angler, someone that looks at two mil tips all the time, they look very fine. What would you say? Would you say still be able to, good visibility when you're seeing them in the water?
Well, absolutely, because these are a fibre tip on them. So a little bit of float education here. A lot of people, they look at these smaller floats and they look and they see this fine tip and think, that's really thin, I'm not going to be able to see that. Whereas you should be thinking, well, that's fibre, where you can tell it's fibre because it's really kind of stiff. Feels like you can bend it a little bit, but it's almost like it's gonna snap. So that means it's glass, so actually the light shines through it and these actually glow really, really bright. Whereas for comparison, we do have a Simon Willsmore River float. See, that's got a plastic bristle on it, which so that bends a lot more freely. So although that's a thicker tip, the material on this is far more visible because the light shines through it. So that's a little bit of a tip if you're looking for your floats. Look at the material it's made of, not just the thickness of the tip. It's nice and stiff fibre, you're going to see it. It's soft plastic like that. It's not quite so visible, then you're going to need the thicker float.
Isn't it amazing how, as anglers, when we get bigger items like poles, we appreciate the technology and the thinking behind it. You look at a float, you just think it's a tip, a body, a stem. And
yeah, you think thin tip, small fish.
That's it.
Thick tip, yeah. You're not thinking about kind of the visibility or the buoyancy of it. You can get a thick tip that's just...
But it shows that there's buoyant, so much work goes into making the right float. And I can only assume that would, you know, as it's a roach pattern, yeah, a silverfish pattern, that's going to be very sensitive and you're going to be able to see everything on that.
Absolutely, it's what it's designed for, more sensitive fishing. Simon's actually just used these recently on the Thames Festival, where he caught 50 pounds of roach over several days on them. He absolutely loves...
Durable, then.
loves these, and I found them a little bit recognisable as well. They're actually based on the old Preston PT 6 pattern.
Okay.
Very popular pattern, but it's now sadly discontinued, and there's an awful lot of people who are still hunting out that float in particularly in the Fenland regions, but they're no longer available. So the tips on them were a little bit too long, the stem's probably slightly too long, so Simon's corrected those, and that is his version of them. So if you like the PT6, can't get hold of them, check out these instead.
Absolutely, like you said, a nice bit of stability with the body. Would you say that's kind of all around in terms of like still waters, flowing waters? Is it quite a versatile float in that sense?
Yeah, still water or a slow moving water. If you're going to use it on a river, it's going to be a slower moving river or kind of a little bit higher off the bottom with sort of smaller baits. You know, it's not quite your double caster or worm float. It's, you know, catching lots and lots of smaller fish, really. Lots of roach, Fenland drains where you could be fishing indeed for hundreds of fish.
So, absolutely. A lovely pattern. They're certainly worth a look, them, aren't they?
Yeah, if you're into your silverfish fishing, then definitely worth a check out. As we said, they're not in every shop, but if you check out bigger people like Bennick Sports or Alex Bates at Tackle and Baits, they'll have these in stock and be able to order them online.
Excellent. Lovely. Right, on to baity stuff now.
Yep.
So usually a lot of baity stuff we end up doing, like Dynamite, Sonya Baits, Bait Tech. These have been, I wouldn't call them a new player, but one of the newer players is Advantage Baits. Now, this is effectively Daiwa's bait side of things.
Yeah.
Will Rooston on the front. And the one I picked up today is I would say this is the perfect sort of mix for this time of year. Now, we're on commercials where we've been chucking lots of fish meal in. It's all been about high fish meal value. The fish have been on it. You know, they're after a lot of food. While things need to tone down at this time of year, fish meal is just, it's powerful, isn't it?
Yep.
It's a powerful ingredient, so you need to tone down your fish meal, but still an essential ingredient to some extent, especially on commercials, because of the amount of pellets and things that are going in. So this, I would say, is probably the ideal ground bait for this time of year. This is the sweet fish meal. Nice dark mix, and I just think when the water starts to clear, you look at any top angler this time of year, they're using dark mixes, aren't they? I said an element of fish meal, but not too much. And I think this is the perfect sort of thing. I've mixed them up before, and this looks like the sort of thing where you could put it into balls, you could put it through a cage. It's
what sort of smell we got? What do you reckon's in it?
Well, you describe it. Have a little honk of that. You tell me what you think that is. How would you describe it?
That's sweet, but then. Oh, it's almost something a little bit kind of savoury about that as well.
You're not getting your head blown off with fish meal, though, are you?
No, not at all.
Which is exactly what it's trying to do. And do you know something else I really like about this? Do you remember last time we talked about the Preston shot leaders? And I said on the back it had the QR code, and I said it was all about making things simple. Well, take a look at that. It has got a bag of ground bait, that costs you £4, £3.99 most retailers, which I would say for a kilo is probably a quid cheaper than a lot of other kilos. It's usually a fiver, so it's a little bit cheaper. You know, if you start using that all year round and you add it up, you're going to save money, you know. So that's quite a good saving. And it's used by Will Rayson and people within the Daiwa stable.
Yep.
They ain't going to use rubbish. It's a quality ground bait. You've only got to look at... You don't have to look at Will's results. Everyone knows how good he is and what he wins. And this is what he's relying on at the moment. But on the back, it shows you how to mix it. So you add too much water to, or too little ground bait, water to your ground bait at the start, you can easily just make a mess of it, and that's it, gone for the day. You know, you can say and leave it to dry out, but it never works. Once you've added too much water, it never comes back. This tells you exactly how to mix it to the consistency. It's got instructions on how you should riddle it, how you should atomize it, all that. Just so that if you're thinking, oh, how much water do I need to put onto this? How long do I need to leave it to stand? Just what I came back to you last time, making it simple for people. We shouldn't assume, we don't know if a beginner's picking that up or whether it's a world champion. We don't know who's picking it up. So I think we should talk as though everyone's a beginner. If you don't need the instructions, tip it in and crack on. But if you do, and you're thinking, I've never used this ground bait before, what's the best ratio of water? What's the best way to mix it? Follow them instructions and you'll have a consistency which is perfect. Just binds together, sticks into a feeder, makes into a ball, which is what you want at this time of year. So again, like I said last time to Preston, thumbs up with those QR codes, thumbs up to Advantage Baits, but just, like I just said, not assuming everyone knows everything.
Very nice. Thank you very much. I'll look forward to trying this today then.
Absolutely. Make sure you follow the instructions. I'm not sure you're quite at the standard now.
So, enjoying your cup holder? Mm. You finished with that?
I'm done with it. But now I've crushed it, it doesn't fit in there, which is a bit of an issue.
Well, I have just the solution here.
Oh, this is convenient, isn't it?
I know.
Anyone
would have thought we'd set that up. But this is, well, we've already had a product by Tackle Tidy. This is called the Bank Tidy by a company called Midwater. So
I assume it's a bin. So that goes in there. Midwater. This is not a name I'm familiar with. Give us a little bit of background. I'm genuinely not familiar with this.
Well, they're a British company. They specialise really in bags, you know, like bespoke luggage and sort of stuff like that. But over recent years, they've started doing more and more for the angling market. And you imagine most of the stuff, you know, comes from China or abroad with the cost of shipping going up and up. Buying something that's made in Britain is actually becoming more and more affordable. So you think that's, how much do you reckon that is?
Well, I just think in the market where we go these days, you see products, again, what we were talking about, the Tackle Tidy, which, as I said, was a good price point.
Yeah.
I think you see products sometimes, you think, that's nice. So I would say it's probably going to be 15 to 20 quid.
Nah, it's £7.99.
You see, again, that's sort of the price point.
For 15 to 20 quid, people would just take a bit a plastic bag with them.
They would.
But that's...
That's really
good. That's kind of nice, because when you're fishing, you've never really got anywhere to put your rubbish, do you? It ends up stuffed in drawers or line or anything like that. But you see how they've made it like a pyramid design?
Yeah.
So, even on that sloping bank, it's just going to sit upright. It's not going to blow away. You can place it next to your box. Got a little Velcro top on it. You can just...
It's got a line in as well, which you can wipe out.
Bits and pieces in it, yeah. Well, it's washable if you fancied washing your bin. But no, for me, just all your bits and pieces in it, and then afterwards you can drop it in with the rest of your kit, empty it out at home, and you would have thought it would just be a dead easy thing, you know, keeping fisheries tidy. But speak to any fishery owner, and you talk to them about rubbish left on their venue, it just absolutely drives them up the wall. So I think if everyone had one of these, that's another excuse out the way, isn't it? You know, no more trailing line.
Yeah.
Stuff like that.
I'm the sort of angler, I always take my rubbish home, but then I'll get home and I'll get on the bank next time and I find my mouldy sandwich. I haven't got a system. Again, talking about this, you don't have a system which then ends up leaves you being a bit of here, there and everywhere. You know, if you just have somewhere to put your rubbish, end of the day, all in one place, tip it rather than having a bit of rubbish in a side drawer, a bit of rubbish in a bag and collect it.
Yeah. You've got it to put... Every time you get your disgorger out, you knock another bit of rubbish out, don't you? It drives you up the wall because you find it tucked everywhere. Or you unzip your pocket, it's in your pocket. So, yeah, one place, lovely little well-made product, and that's dirt cheap, really, to be honest. It always seems too good to be a bin. You might as well use it as a little carry-all or a real bag, or you can carry all sorts of bits and pieces in that. You can actually carry your sandwiches in it, to be honest.
It's, I mean, what can you buy for 8 quid these days? You can't buy anything for 8 quid, you know?
Yeah.
I went to Aldi last night, and I got a piece of gammon. It was 7 quid. that'll be gone in a day. That'll last you forever. So, it's that's a brilliant thing. And you know what? It's really nice. It's genuinely nice. We've had a few smaller companies come to us and say, do you mind taking a look at this for us? And it's nice to, because again, until we'd had a little conversation, genuinely, until about an hour before we came on camera, I'd never seen it. I'd never heard of Midwater. Dan gave us a little bit of, and it's nice to see other people bringing something to the market, isn't it?
Yeah, well, this is just one of their smaller kind of niche products. I understand a portable bin for fishing is not going to be everybody's cup of tea. Like, well, to be fair, the specimen anglers, they're probably going to absolutely lap it up. You think, you know, you're camping for several sort of days, but more to the point, if you've got like an item that you want to get to the bank, there's no item of luggage out there that properly holds it, they'll make it for you. They do all sorts of bits. They do side tray bags, they do bait boat bags, they do carry-alls, and all of it is, it's surprisingly cheap. Like, you can get items especially made to your exact size requirements for like 30 or 40 pounds.
Brilliant.
It's like, you can't even buy stuff off the shelf for that price, but they will make it to your exact size and requirements for that. So,
it's brilliant.
Really
excellent.
Promising products from a very, very handy company to know about.
And I've just ditched my empty can of Coke on you, so win-win.
But I've got your bag of ground bait, though.
Oh, all right, you win. Well, we've covered everything, a bit of everything there, bait,
yep.
Rod, bits and pieces, and just like that, we've flown through five again.
Yeah, yeah.
And as always, guys, we hope you've enjoyed it. We really do genuinely want to hear your suggestions, what we want to see. You know, we can get in touch with manufacturers and things like that. If there's something you want us to have a look at, we will genuinely have a look at it and we'll genuinely tell you what we think. So,
yeah. You
know, post in the comments below here. And until that next time, Dan, I think it's going to be cold. It's going to be cold, isn't it? We've got to do a weather watch,
yeah,
ain't we?
Yeah, it's
a bit autumnal, but it's October. I think it's going to be cold, but fingers crossed it ain't. But until then, tight lines and take care, guys.
See you later, guys.